So today I'm going to show you how to intertwine and overlap elements within Procreate. It's way easier than just erasing and having to redraw your lines because it's such a pain in the butt. A waste of time, to be honest. I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's create something. Welcome back to another video here at Swag Talks. If you haven't noticed already, we have kind of shifted our focus to design-based things like tutorials and things like that. We're just two designers who like to use our skills to glorify the Lord, and when we can teach people how to use their skills like that too, it's a blessing. Here I have my text, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw just like a nice little flourish thing. You can do this with florals as well. I'm going to go to my monoline brush because it's pretty easy. And then I'm just going to kind of do this. Maybe wrap around like that. So what you're going to want to do, this is actually called masking. You're going to select the layer that you just drew on with the thing that you want to intertwine and overlap, and then click mask. And now this is important, so it's going to come up with this layer mask, and what this is basically saying is that whatever you do on this layer mask, whatever this darker blue layer mask is selected, is going to affect your original layer that you masked it to. So the way that you do this properly is you take your paintbrush and you're going to paint in white or in black. That will determine what will reveal and what will conceal it. You can remember by saying white reveals and black conceals. So if I want to hide something, I'm gonna go to my black color and then make sure I'm on the paintbrush and on the layer mask. And I'm going to just intertwine here. So let's see, I think I want it to overlap this way. So I'm gonna hide this part. Isn't that cool? Like, I'm painting with black and it's just hiding that. So that's overlapped and I want to keep that. And then let's say I want to hide this part because I want it to come underneath this part of the N. What? So cool, right? And let's say I change my mind and I actually want that to be overlapped. I can just take my white color and then reveal it. So let's see, I'm just gonna keep playing around with it. Also, this is really cool because as you can probably tell, it's easy to go over by accident, right? So because you're not actually erasing this ribbon, you in your painting, you can just easily bring it back and then adjust as needed, which I often have to do because my hand is not as steady as I want it to be, but yeah. Also, another thing to know is that you'll want true white and true black, because if it's like a gray, or even if you like accidentally paint with a color, you can see up here that it, even if you're on a color, it will still default to gray. And so when I paint with that, it's kind of like it's a lower opacity of that line. So this could be a cool effect if you want to do it that way. I don't, so I'm going to go back and just erase. Well, actually, I'm not even erasing, you guys, I'm masking. So another cool trick that I have seen is if you are kind of unsure if there's an area like this where it overlaps but not as much as you want it to, or you're just not really sure where the lines cross, you can just do a simple like turning down the opacity on the layer. So you can click on your layer and then just turn down the opacity, and then you can see here where it overlaps, and that might help you paint in a way that will help your process. And this is what the final result looks like. You can see that everything is wrapped around. It looks really cool. You can get super creative with this. I mean, there's so many ways that you can use this to your advantage. You can make it look like it's an actual ribbon, you know, with like the little with the little things on the end. That's kind of cute. So yeah, you could do, you know, a shadow that's the same color as the ribbon, and then that could blend in really well, so you don't have to go back and make those adjustments. And yeah, that, now you know. And the more you know, the more you go, I guess. Thank you so much for watching that. This, no, this, not that. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to learn how to letter using grid builders, I will link that here in the description below so you can check that out. Be sure to share this with people who may want to know how to make your life easier and like a dream with intertwining elements using masking. It is so well worth it. I highly recommend it. If you found value in this video, please give it a like and hit subscribe if you want to see more content like this. It makes my day whenever we get a new subscriber. It really makes me happy. So until next time, stay creative.